Praise God, wherever you are this wonderful day. We are grateful to the gift of life, the gift of the Holy Spirit, the gift of the faithfulness of the Most High God. To learn power to become, my dear friends, we are going to talk about keep your eyes on the good. Keep your eyes on the good. And this is to enable us to focus every single time when trials, tribulations, and difficulties come to our lives, to understand that focusing on what is good is important. Whatever we focus on, our faith is always built on that, and our belief is built on that. I think that faith, of course, comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. That is a truth. But I've also said, if you listen to me before, I said that believing God comes from ourselves. And more often than not, believing God comes from our own human experiences and what we aspire to see, what we aspire to become, what we believe actually is due to us. So when I'm saying focus on the good, it's when I keep my eyes on what is good, what is wonderful, it is easier for me to believe for better. Because one of the obstacles you have when you're trying to have a breakthrough from the Lord is the primary and most important foundation, which is believing for better. Believing for better. And that's the thing that we normally struggle with. It is easier for us to go on the negative very, very quickly, and still out of the negative, hope to derive the faith and the belief required for a breakthrough. It is very difficult, my dear friends, to transition from a place of being neutral to a place of being negative, then believing God from a negative place for a positive outcome. It is actually better for you to be, or for you to see a negative, to see something negative, but choose to have a positive focus in that situation, and that helps you to believe God for the better. The dynamics of faith and belief are very tricky, and I'll teach about that in the class, maybe in the coming year. But the dynamics of them are very tricky. And where you put your eyes determines how much you choose to believe. And I want to read from Philippians 4:8, which says this: Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsever things are good, whatever things are of good report, emphasis, are of good report, if they be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Paul is teaching them something very important, because if I learn to put my, at least the same chapter where he comes to talk about very interesting things, this is the same chapter he comes to talk about, but my Lord shall supply all of your needs a bit later on. It's the same chapter where he talks about, I've learned how to be low and I've learned how to be high. Same chapter. Philippians chapter 4 is a very interesting chapter just to read about perspective. Even before he talks about the Lord supplying your needs, he focuses so much on perspective. May the peace of the Lord, that's verse 8, that passes all understanding, be upon you. He's focusing so much on our own spiritual compass or emotional compass or psychological compass that before I even begin to receive these things, I must understand where to look and how to believe. I have to keep my mind on those things that are true, that are honest, and that are of good report. That I have to push out negative reports from my life. Naysayers, people who want to break my spirit and break my break my will, break my belief, break my understanding. It is very important, because this is the same scripture. He talks about I can do all things through Christ. Same Philippians 4. I can do all things through Christ. That's 4:13. So Philippians chapter 4 basically is Paul talking about there is a power available, you know, that my Lord shall supply all of your needs. And people normally think at times that the needs are just financial needs, but at times it's the strength I need, the grace I need, the anointing that I need. All that is the Lord's supply. All that is the Lord's supply. But where does my mind go? My focus is on what is good. I have to keep my mind on what is good. That good report. And my dear friends, there is no other good report you'll ever find. No other good report you'll ever find than the gospel. That Jesus loves you. He paid the price for you, but you may have life and life in full. That is the good report. That's a good report above a doctor's report, above any report, that Christ paid the price for you. So let us pray in confidence. Dear Lord, I praise you, I worship you, Father, I glorify you for your goodness and your mercy that endures forever. Lord, may your Holy Spirit rest upon your sons and rest this day, Lord. As they go out, whatever they do, Father, I pray that, Lord, you'll keep their minds focused on you and focused on your goodness, focused on how much you've invested that they may have life and life in full. I pray that, Lord, you eliminate all negative thoughts, all negative words, all negative company, that, Father, they may focus on the good thing, the good report which comes from you. So, Father, may you give them the strength they need, the grace they need, the anointing that they need today. Because, Father, you are faithful, your love endures forever. Just in the name of Jesus, thanksgiving, amen. Stay blessed. See you again next time, same time.